Hello everyone, my name is Mandeep Kaur. I'm an aerospace engineer. I'm working with Aircruise Aviation Private Limited as an aviation manager. So today I will be giving you a brief knowledge about basic flight maneuvers. Before we begin with it, here's a close look to my bio. You can follow me on social media through these links. So let's get started with today's topic. So what is basically a flight maneuver? Airplanes operate in an environment that is unlike an automobile. Drivers tend to drive with a fairly narrow field of view and focus primarily on forward motion. Beginning pilots tend to practice the same. Flight instructors face the challenge of teaching beginning pilots about attitude awareness, which requires understanding the motions of flight. An airplane rotates in bank, pitch, and yaw while also moving horizontally, vertically, and laterally. The four fundamentals, straight and level flight, turns, climbs, and descents, are the principal maneuvers that control the airplane through the six motions of the flight. So through this small video, you can see the motion of an aircraft, so how it is banking, pitching, and yawing, and changing its motion according to the flight. So this is a cockpit picture. Here I can see the different control panels. So this shows the turn, that various controls. So first we have the aileron banks. So through these, the aircraft can bank to the left or to the right. Then next to that, we have the elevator pitch, which is used to pitch up or pitch down the aircraft. And just below we have the pedals. So the first one is the rudder paddle, and then next is the yaw paddle. So the rudder paddle and the yaw paddle, these are just control surfaces of an aircraft. And just next to that, we have a throttle, which is used to control the thrust of an aircraft. And then we have a propeller as well as a mixture, which is used as the flight control. So this is the basic flight control and the instrument panels. So the aircraft needs three basic controls, and these basic controls or primarily control surfaces are named as aileron, elevator or stabilizer, as well as the third one, the rudder. So what these control surfaces are used for? So the first one, which is aileron, which is on the longitudinal axis of the rotation of an aircraft, it is used for the roll movement of an aircraft. The next one, which is elevator or the stabilizer, this is basically along the lateral axis of the rotation of an aircraft, and this is used to pitch the aircraft, that is to pitch up or to pitch down. Then next we have is rudder, which is along the vertical axis of rotation of an aircraft, and this is basically used for the yawing movement of an aircraft. So here we can clearly see the aircraft roll motion. So while an aircraft banking, it uses ailerons as the control surface. So if an aircraft has to roll, then its ailerons goes in the alternate position, as like if the right aileron goes up, then the left aileron goes down and vice versa. So that is how an aircraft roll motion is being done. So next to that, we have aircraft yaw motion. So this yaw motion is basically for left or right turn. So this yaw motion is controlled by the control surface, which is at the tail position of an aircraft. And this control surface is known as the rudder. So it turns left or right. So this here we can see a clear motion of an aircraft yaw. So at the last, we have the aircraft pitch motion. So the control surface of the pitch motion are located at the tail section of an aircraft, which are also known as elevators. So this position of the elevators goes along with the motion. Either if the elevator goes up, both of the control surfaces will go simultaneously up or simultaneously down. So this is basically used for the up or down movement of an aircraft, or nose up, that is pitch up, or pitch down of the aircraft. So this is a 3D view of both of the three, all the three motions are combined into the single position. So here we have a roll motion. Next we have is yaw motion, and then we have pitch motion. So it is right now in the yaw motion, and then it will forward pitch motion, pitch which is up and down, and roll will be banking to the left or to the right, and yaw will be left or right turn. So as these are control surfaces which are followed by some angles, so if an aircraft has to pitch up or pitch down, then the angle made through the central axis of an aircraft to the pitch angle, this is known as pitch angle. And if an aircraft has to roll, then its angle goes from this lateral axis, then this angle is known as the roll angle of an aircraft. So here we have a clear, the center position of an aircraft is the steady level or straight level. So it is followed by a nose up or pitch up, and then behind it we have the pitch down of an aircraft. Similarly, the bank control shows the center position of an aircraft, which is straight and steady level aircraft. So this shows how an aircraft from front view looks like when it banks to the left and banks to the right. So this is a small video which shows the maneuvering of an aircraft, and it involves all the banking, pitching, and yawing of an aircraft. So it is taking a steep and steady turns also. So that is how an aircraft maneuvering is done by using its control surfaces. So if I talk about straight and level flight, so how does the view from the cockpit look like? So here we can see some instruments showing the position of the aircraft. The first instrument here we have turn coordinator, which simply shows the position of an aircraft. So it here the aircraft position is showing the straight and level. Then next to that, here we have the another instrument where it is showing the position of an aircraft with respect to the horizon. Then next to that, we have another instrument, which is also showing the position of the aircraft. So at the panel, which is at the right corner, it is a multifunction display here, which shows the position of the aircraft. And as well as from the head-up display, we can see the view outside, and it is showing the straight and level flight. For a clear view, we will have further photographs. So what is basically straight and level flight? In learning to control the airplane in level flight, it is important that the pilot be taught to maintain a light touch on the flight controls using fingers, rather than the common problem of a test fist palm wrapped around the flight controls. The pilot should exert only enough pressure on the flight controls to produce the desired result. The pilot should learn to associate the apparent movement of the references with the control pressures which produce attitude movement. So here we have a photo for a straight and steady level aircraft. If an aircraft has a pitch up or has a nose high, so it is showing from the head-up display, it is showing the position of an aircraft with reference to the neutral horizon reference point. So next we have a nose level, that is a steady level aircraft, and it is showing the position of an aircraft with respect to the natural horizon reference point. So this is the nose level or straight aircraft in a steady level position. So if the nose is low, then it is the natural horizon reference point. So here we can see a clear view that how aircraft nose is down, so how the distance is being maximized through the natural horizon reference point. For all practical purposes, the airplane's airspeed remains constant in straight and level flight if the power setting is also constant. intentional airspeed changes by increasing or decreasing the engine power provide proficiency in maintaining straight and level flight as the airplane's airspeed is changing. Pitching movement may be also generated by extension and retraction of flaps, landing gears, and other drag-producing devices such as spoilers. Exposure to the effect of the various configurations should be covered in any specific airplane checkout. So next to that, to ease the control surfaces, we use trim control. Proper trim technique is an important and often overlooked basic flying skill. An improperly trimmed airplane requires constant flight control pressures from the pilot, produces tension and fatigue, which distracts the pilot from the outside visual scanning and contribute to abrupt and erratic airplane attitude control input. So this picture is shown. Here we have the elevator trim wheel and some elevator trim indicator. So basically, elevator trim is used in airplane to null the pressure exerted by the pilot on the pitch of the flight control. So how does, where does trim tab located and how is it works? So trim tab is located at the nose part of an aircraft just behind the elevator. So if the elevator goes down, the trim tab goes up. And if the elevator goes up, the trim tab goes down. So it works opposite as the elevator, and it is basically used to ease the control of the pilot. So here is a visual of elevator trim tabs at the tail section of an aircraft. So this is my bio. If you wish, you can connect me on the social media also. So this is the book which is written by Captain Shekhar Gupta. So you can buy this book from the Amazon. It is available. You can see this cover and go to the Amazon and buy this book. So this is basically Pilot's Career Guide. So that was all about my today's presentation. I hope you would like it. Thank you so much for listening to me.